Hello, and welcome to FlexSim 2025. Let's dive in and see what's new. First, some aesthetics. If you prefer a dark theme for your software, there's never been a better time to try it out in FlexSim. Go to File, then Global Preferences, and click the Environment tab to find this option and change your theme. FlexSim has had a dark mode option for a while now, but we've continued to refine this interface theme and included additional support in FlexSim 2025. This version also introduces a new object, the container. Containers give you the ability to represent an assembly of multiple simulation objects, allowing you to do things like organize your model into floors, or treat a work cell as a single object in your model. This offers several key benefits, including better management of complex models and more efficient model development. It even enables users to more effectively work on different portions of the same model, as containers allow your model to be more modular and easier to merge. When you drag a container into the 3D view, it will open a separate container view window. This is where you will add objects, adjust their layout, and make connections. When you manipulate the container in the 3D view, it will behave like a single object. Click the Fit Size to Contents button in the container's properties to resize the bounding box to cover all objects in the container. There is also an Edit in Place checkbox to edit the container objects in the 3D view without having to use the container view. You can make connections to and from individual objects in the container, and containers can make use of FlexSim's powerful templating features to quickly create and edit multiple work cells. FlexSim 2025 also brings convenient new features for analyzing and debugging your simulation models. First up is the task sequence queue. Simply right-click on any task executor and click View Task Sequence Queue. This will allow you to see this resource's active task sequence, as well as their queue of tasks. The second is a new feature added to the events list. If you click on a time cell in the event list viewer, there is a blue arrow that can be clicked to have the simulation fast forward to that specific event time. These features will give you more information and control in your simulation runs. One final new feature we'll highlight is the utilization by hour chart template. It uses a time plot to chart how often objects were utilized each hour. And it doesn't need to only be by the hour. You can choose a different time interval, from a week down to a second. There are more new features to explore, so check out the release notes, and we hope you enjoy FlexSim 2025.